This is Another Sign of the Times, Commentary and Analysis, Sagging Consumer Confidence. Confidence among the nation's consumers stagnated near a two-year low in September, and the share of households that said it was difficult to find a job climbed to the highest level in almost three decades. A research group has said the conference board, said its sentiment index increased to 45.4 from a revised August reading of 45.2, which was the lowest since April 2009. A report on home prices showed values dropped less than had been forecast in the year ended in July. The confidence reading signals that hiring has not improved since August, when the economy failed to create jobs and the unemployment rate held at 9.1% officially. Falling stock prices and concern that the crisis in Europe will undermine the global recovery may also be shaking Americans' resolve, raising the risk that spending will cool during the holiday shopping season. Consumers remain very concerned about income, employment, and the state of the economy, said a senior fixed income strategist at State Street Global Markets in Boston. All of these factors point to even weaker labor market conditions as we get closer to the end of the year. The Standard & Poor's Case-Shiller Index of property values in 20 cities fell 4.1% in July, compared with the same month in 2010, the group said. The median forecast of 28 economists surveyed had projected a 4.4% decline. Values were little changed in July from the prior month, after adjusting for seasonal changes. Investigations into bank foreclosure practices caused lags in processing that may have helped stabilize prices in recent months, said a housing economist at Moody's Analytics in Westchester, Pennsylvania. Due to foreclosure processing delays, fewer distressed sales are occurring relative to normal sales, with more distressed homes likely to be sold in coming months. House prices will depreciate further before they stabilize. That is a best-case scenario. Economists expected that the conference board's September confidence gauge would climb to 46, according to the median forecast. In a Bloomberg survey, estimates ranged from 40 to 49 in the survey of 74 economists. The index averaged 98 during the economic expansion that ended in December 2007. The conference board's data showed a measure of present conditions declined to 32.5, the lowest since January, from 34.3 in August. The measure of expectations for the next 6 months rose to 54 from 52.4, and the share of consumers who said jobs were hard to get increased to 50, the highest level since May 1983. 48.5 in August. That may signal a worsening of the September employment data. Confidence dropped in 6 of 9 regions, according to the report. The percentage of respondents in the conference board survey expecting more jobs to become available in the next 6 months rose to 12% from 11.8% the previous month. The proportion expecting their incomes to rise over the next 6 months decreased to 13.3%, the lowest since October, from 14.3% in August. In other words, the economy is still bad and, most likely, is getting worse and will get worse before it gets better. And this, too, is another sign of the end times, transition days, which is a time of extraordinary changes, happenings, and events. Everything that must change quickly or rapidly, and for the better, because it's about what kind of world are we leaving to the future generations. This should be a very important question to ask. Remember, there's something much more going on here. It's also called fate or destiny. Revelation chapter 6, verse 5. And when he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, "Come and see." And I beheld, and lo, a black horse, and he that sat on him had a pair of balances in his hand. 6. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, A measure of wheat for a penny, and 3 measures of barley for a penny. And see, thou hurt not the oil and the wine. 7. And when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast say, Come and see. 8. And I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death, and Hell followed with him. And power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth, to kill with weapon, and with hunger, and with death, and with the beasts of the earth. 9. And when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God, for the testimony which they held. 10. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? 11. And white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled. 12. And I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood. 13. And the stars of heaven fell into the earth, even as a fig tree casts her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. 14. And the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together, and every mountain and nation were moved out of their places. 15. And the kings and leaders of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman and working man, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains. 16. And said to the mountains and rocks, Fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sits on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb. 17. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? It's time for all these things to happen, and for all prophecy to be fulfilled. Everything is connected, and everything is numbered, and these are more signs. This is a part of the vision that I have seen.